Arrow 3 ballistic missile defense system has been successfully tested. Several tests of the Arrow 3 was completed in a 10-day-long testing period from Pacific Spaceport Complex, Alaska (PSCA) in Kodiak, Alaska. This is the first time the system was tested outside Israel. The test was conducted by the Israeli Missile Defense Organization (IMDO) in cooperation with the U.S. Missile Defense Agency (MDA). Israel had earlier planned to conduct the test in late 2018, but this was delayed. The Israeli Minister of Defense stated at the time that the delay was to improve the system's readiness. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes successful testing of Arrow 3 by U.S. and Israel. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. There's an increasing concern in Israel and the U.S. about Iran's ballistic missile program. Iran's been developing a range of missiles that could pose a genuine threat. The Shahab 3 is a medium-range ballistic missile (MRBM) developed by Iran and is based on the North Korean Nodong-1. Shahab 3ER extended range is thought to have a maximum range of 1,200 miles or 2,000 kilometers, which enables it to reach Israel. The announcement of the Arrow 3 tests came just days after Iran test-fired a Shahab 3. Prima facie, there's no link between the two, and the timing seems coincidental. But in the larger context, these tests come at a time when there's a state of simmering tension in the Middle East. Tensions in the region escalated after the U.S. government, under President Trump, unilaterally withdrew from Iran's nuclear deal, accusing Iran of misusing the deal, and has imposed stringent sanctions against Iran. The deal offered Iran relief from sanctions in exchange for limits on its nuclear program. Recent months have seen multiple spikes in hostilities, which include U.S. accusing Iran for a series of attacks on commercial ships and Iran downing of American RQ-4A Global Hawk drone. Britain moved into the crisis when its Royal Marines captured the Iranian tanker Grace 1 off the coast of Gibraltar. Israel has already been embroiled in indirect conflict with Iran and has been carrying out airstrikes on Iranian targets in several regions. Arrow 3 is the latest missile in the Arrow series of missile. Israel Aerospace Industries (IAI) and Boeing have been developing Arrow 3 together since 2008, with financial and other support from the U.S. government. IAI began preliminary tests of the Arrow 3 in 2011. The Arrow 3 is an exo-atmospheric hypersonic anti-ballistic missile jointly funded, developed, and produced by Israel and the United States. It's overseen by the Israeli Ministry of Defense's HOMA administration and the U.S. Missile Defense Agency. It provides exo-atmospheric interception of ballistic missiles, mid-course flight phase of the trajectory, including ICBMs, that's intercontinental ballistic missiles, carrying nuclear, chemical, biological, or conventional warheads. Arrow 3, like the Arrow 2, is a two-stage interceptor. Arrow 3 can be launched into an area of space before it's known where the target missile is heading. Once the course of the incoming missiles is identified, the Arrow interceptor is redirected using its thrust vectoring nozzle to close the gap and conduct a hit-to-kill interception. Unlike most kill vehicles, which use liquid or gas propulsion, the Arrow 3 kill vehicle will be propelled by an ordinary rocket motor equipped with a thrust vectoring nozzle. The kill vehicle can switch directions, allowing it to take down even fast-moving maneuvering targets. An Arrow 3 battery is expected to intercept salvos of more than 5 ballistic missiles within 30 seconds. The missile has a reported range of up to 1,500 miles or 2,400 kilometers and can reach an altitude of 62 miles or 100 kilometers. Because of its ability to reach this kind of altitude, it could be utilized as an anti-satellite weapon too. Given the fact that Arrow 3 is a bit smaller weight, around half of Arrow 2, the system could be mounted in warships in the future. Arrow 3 system uses ELTA's L-band Green Pine Family of Active Electronically Scanned Array (EASA) radar for target detection and tracking. Israeli Missile Defense Organization (IMDO) Director Moshe Patel said in a statement on July 28, 2019, 10 challenging years of development have culminated in this moment. The Arrow 3 weapon system completed a test campaign, during which an Arrow 3 interceptor completed full interception of the target. He added, "This is an extraordinary operational and technological achievement for the State of Israel, made possible by thousands of employees, engineers and officers from the Ministry of Defense, Israeli Defense Industries, Israeli Air Force, and our U.S. partners." Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu declared during a cabinet meeting on the same day, "Arrow 3 gives Israel the ability to act against ballistic missiles fired against us from Iran and from any other location." He added, "The performance was perfect. Every hit a bullseye." According to IMDO and MDA, during the 10-day-long testing period, Arrow 3 system fired 3 interceptors on 3 separate occasions against mock ballistic missiles and was able to successfully intercept each one. The main reason for Israel testing the Arrow 3 in Alaska is space constraints. IMDO's Patel told reporters after the announcement of the conclusion of the tests, "Arrow 3 is too big for the State of Israel. It's supposed to be good against nuclear threats that are coming from Iran. We have limitations in our arena to conduct flight tests because of safety." In Alaska, IMDO and MDA were able to undertake more realistic tests that represented threats coming from extended ranges. It's to be noted that before this test, IMDO had already conducted several test launches in Israel itself to validate the basics of the missile. Neither IMDO nor MDA provided details of the kind of missile that was used to simulate the threat, but MDA's press release suggested the intercepts were at exo-atmospheric level. Both Israel and the U.S. have several kinds of missiles that could be used for simulation purpose, and they could replicate the behavior of missiles like Iranian Shahab 3. NDA stated it provided an X-band ANTPY-2 radar to help with target detection and queuing. So the Arrow 3 in this test was using ANTPY-2 apart from its own L-band Green Pine radar. Israel has a multi-tier missile defense system. This includes the Iron Dome for short-range rockets, David's Sling, which is similar to American Patriot for point defense, and Arrow 2 for intermediate-range ballistic missiles. Arrow 3, designed for ICBM interception, will be at the uppermost tier of the shield. It will be a critical addition to the defensive umbrella, and in coming days will make Israel's missile defense a mature and rounded one. The relatively small landmass, along with the overlapping multi-tier missile defense, will make Israel one of the most well-defended countries against missiles. Viewers may note that the U.S. government's most recent missile defense policy, published by the Pentagon in January 2019, pointed to the importance of U.S.-Israeli cooperation and plans to expand those efforts. In the grounds, too, the relation has been strengthened. In March 2019, the United States military had deployed a THAAD battery to Israel for the first time. The deployment of THAAD in Israel was part of dynamic force employment concept and is aligned to missile defense review. U.S. military's latest missile defense review has called for enhancement in cooperation with regional allies, such as Israel. So, in essence, it can be said that Israel and the U.S. are working very closely when it comes to missile defense, and this is expected to result in the development of very advanced capabilities in the coming days.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.